नमो भगवते वसुदेवाय
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
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 So, we've been recounting the last couple of weeks. We spoke about Lord Rishabhdev, and we told how Lord Rishabhdev had 100 sons, and the senior most of his 100 sons was Bharat Maharaj.
我们前几节课一直都是讲述的是主Rishabhdev的逍遥。
So Bharat Maharaj was a great devotee, and when his father retired to the forest to do austerities, Bharat became the king.
Bharat Maharaj 是位伟大的奉献者，当他的父亲退隐到森林去苦行的时候。
And he ruled the planet exactly as he had been instructed by his father. According to the Vedic principles and guided by the Brahmanas. And so Bharat Maharaj, he by desire of his father, he accepted a wife who was from a very good family, and together in their family life they had 5 sons.
Bharat Maharaj, 按照父亲的意愿娶了一位妻子。
So, when Bharat Maharaj became the ruler, he became the ruler of the planet, this whole planet was named after him. It became known as Bharat Varsha.
在这个星球上当统治者的时候，这个星球就以它的名字命名为Bharatvarsha。
Even today, sometimes India is referred to as Bharatvarsha.
至今，印度仍有些人以Bharatvarsha的名字称呼印度。
So when he was the king. Bharat Maharaj was very learned, very knowledgeable, and he ruled very well. He kept himself always engaged. He made sure everyone was doing their proper duties according to their ashram and varna.
Bharat Maharaj 是既博学又知识。 他非常好的统治了星球，他确保每个臣民都履行各自在 Varna 和 Ashram 当中的职责。It's
the duty of the government to see that the citizens all have proper engagement, they have proper work.
政府的职责就是确保臣民们都各司其职。
Nobody should be unemployed. Everyone should have some duty to perform, some occupation. So it's the duty of the king to make sure that people have appropriate duty according to their qualification.
国王的职责就是要确保每个人都按照他们各自的资格，从事各自的职责。
When the people have proper employment, then they're happy, they're satisfied.
当每个人他们都有恰当的职责履行的时候，就会变得心满意足，很高兴。
And Bharat Maharaj, he's the king, his duty was to perform sacrifices for the benefit of all of the kingdom.
既然 Bharat Maharaj 是一位国王，他的职责就是要为了全体王国的利益来举行献祭。
Sometimes he would have to do the sacrifice where a horse is sacrificed in the fire.
有的时候他就要必须要举行在火中做马祭。
And then from out of the fire will come a young horse.
从这个火祭当中呢，会出现一匹年轻的骏马。
And he had to do another sacrifice where they would offer a special drink which is offered, which is drank in the heavenly planets called Somaras.
另外一种祭祀呢，是向祭火当中供奉一种饮品饮料，就是在天堂上的居民们所喝的叫 Somaras.
So Bharat Maharaj was a devotee of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but when they would do the sacrifices, they would worship the different demigods.
Bharat Maharaj 是至尊性格神手的奉献者，但是在献祭当中呢，他们要向各位不同的半神人献祭。
Yeah, and Bharat Maharaj understood these different demigods are parts of the body of the Supreme Lord.
Bharat Maharaj 内心明白，这些半神人都是至尊主的躯体的不同部分。
So, usually, of course, devotees will not worship demigods.
通常而言，奉献者不会去崇拜半神人们。
But Bharat Maharaj didn't just worship the demigods independently of the Supreme Lord. He understood they are part of the Supreme Lord.
Bharat Maharaj 并不是独立于主之外单独来崇拜半神人，他明白半神人是主的所属部分。
So he performed all the yajnas for the satisfaction of Lord Krishna.
他为了取悦主 Krishna 而实行了所有的 Yagya 祭祀。
And he knew that the demigods are all parts of Krishna's body.
他明白半神人们都是 Krishna 的躯体的不同部位。
And he knows that the different Vedic mantras also These demigods are all explained in the different mantras, the Vedic mantras.
他也知道这些半神人是为不同的伟大曼陀当，不同的伟大曼陀都描述的这些半神人们。
And these demigods are all controlled by the Supreme Lord Krishna.
这些半神人们都受至尊主 Krishna 所控制着。
So by thinking in this way, Bharat Maharaj was never greedy or lusty. He never got too much attached.
他就以这种方式来行为，因此不会变得贪婪、色欲和依附。
And when they would do the yajna, the priests would make offerings to different demigods.
举行 Yagya 的时候呢，祭司们会向半神人们来献祭。
But Bharat Maharaj knew that these demigods are just a part of the body of the Supreme Lord. Indra is the arm of the Supreme Lord. And Surya, the sun, is like his eye. So like this, he understood all the offerings to the different demigods, they're all parts of the body of the Supreme Lord.
就这样,他明白对这些不同半神的献祭,
so, and for people who don't do devotional service, like hearing and chanting, they have to do their prescribed duty.
对于不做奉献服务的人们, 比如说不去聆听唱诵的人们, 他们必须要履行各自的职责。
So people may say, you know, Bharat Maharaj, if he was a devotee, why did he do all these sacrifices?
有的人就会说, 既然Bharat Maharaj是奉献者, 为什么他要从事这些献祭呢?
But these sacrifices are actually meant for, because these sacrifices are not usually done by devotees, these are usually done by the karmis.
因为这些献祭通常不是奉献者来施行的, 而是由那些karmi们所做的。
But Bharat Maharaj was just following the orders of Krishna.
而Bharat Maharaj仅仅遵守主Krishna的命令。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, surrender to me.
Krishna在《国家梵歌》当中说,
and Krishna says, everything you do, do it as an offering for me.
Krishna said, 无论你做什么, 都把它作为对我的祭祀来做。
So Bharat Maharaj just wanted to please Krishna.
因此, Bharat Maharaj 只想取悦 Krishna.
Yajna is done for the pleasure of Vishnu. And if we satisfy Lord Vishnu, then all the demigods are also satisfied.
而当我们, 令主威士努满意之后,
we don't need to satisfy the demigods independently. We just need to satisfy the Supreme Lord, Krishna or Vishnu.
我们无需去单独满足半神人,而只需要去满足至尊主Krishna或者是Vishnu.
Just like when you water the tree, all the leaves and branches get water.
正如给树根浇水,那树的枝枝叶叶也自动得到了滋养。
So the same way, if we satisfy Lord Vishnu or Krishna, he's the root of all the demigods.
同样, 如果我们满足了Vishnu或Krishna, 因为他们都是半神的根。
Just like if you worship Mother Durga, she creates and maintains the material world.
就比如我们崇拜 Mother Durga 母亲, 她创造并维系着物质世界。
But she's under the control of Krishna.
但她却是在主 Krishna 的控制之下。
So we should worship the demigods as servants of Krishna.
我们应当把半神们当作主 Krishna 仆人加以崇拜。
If we want to worship Lord Shiva, Lord Shiva is also Krishna's body, like Krishna's body.
倘若要崇拜主释了，主释了也是，也仿佛是主 Krishna 的躯体的一部分。
So if we offer respects to Lord Shiva, we should think like that, that we're offering respects to Krishna.
倘若我们要对主释了加以尊重的话，也应当这样想，那就像尊重主 Krishna。
Yeah. And the same is true if you worship Brahma or the sun god Surya or the fire god Agni, the same. They're also part of Krishna.
崇拜 Brahma, Surya, 太阳神、火神 Agni 也是一样的，他们都是 Krishna 的一部分。
So Bharat Maharaj, he did not want to get any blessing from the demigods. He just wanted to please the Supreme Lord.
Bharat Maharaj 并不希望获得半神人们的祝福，他只是想得到至尊主的祝福。
So he did everything like that for the satisfaction of Lord Vishnu.
所以他所做的每件事都是以这种方式来做的，都是为了满足主 Vishnu。
So great kings like Maharaj Ambarish, they were pure devotees, and they would spend all their time in the service of Krishna.
伟大的国王，例如 Maharaj Ambarish, 是主。Krishna 的纯粹奉献者，他总是在恒常的服务 Krishna。
So the pure devotee, he can get other people to help him in the service of Krishna.
纯粹奉献者们可以让别人帮助他服务主 Krishna.
Just like.If you want to do a fire sacrifice, you want to do a yagya, you can get a brahmana, a priest, to do the yagya.
例如，假若要举行火祭 yagya, 就要令 brahmana 们来从事这个祭祀。
Now the brahmanas may not be pure devotees, but we get them to do the yagya.
做祭祀的 Brahmana 也许不是纯粹的奉献者，然而我们让他来做这个火祭。
But the devotee is a pure devotee, and he just wants to please Krishna. So he's getting the Brahmana to do some service for Krishna.
然而，那个奉献者却是纯粹的，他是希望来取悦 Krishna， 所以他就。让这个 Brahmana 来做服务。
So there's no harm to make use of other people, get them also to do service for Krishna.
因此，利用别人来服务 Krishna 没有什么坏处。
So when the devotee does sacrifice, it's for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord.
当奉献者们举行祭祀的时候，是为目的是取悦至尊主。
So Maharaj Bharat did these different yagyas, and in this way he became very pure.
Maharaj Bharat 就举行祭祀，以这种方式变得非常的纯净。
He saw Krishna. He saw the Lord. He saw Lord Krishna.As the personality of Godhead, he saw him also as the super soul, and he could see him also as a Brahman.
他看到主 Krishna 既是至尊性格神手，也是超灵，同时也是 Brahman.
The yogis, they worship the Paramatma.
瑜
And the Gyanis who cultivate knowledge, they worship the impersonal Brahman. But the devotees, they worship Krishna, the Supreme Lord. And the Lord comes also in Vishnu form. Devotees can also worship the Lord as Vishnu or Vasudev.
主也会以Vishnu的形象而降临，因此奉献者们也会崇拜Vishnu或者是崇拜Vasudeva。Vasudeva
holds that he has the four arms and he holds the symbols of Vishnu, the conch shell and the club and the Sudarshan chakra and the lotus flower.
Vasudeva拥有四臂。
lotus flower and
lotus,
and club, the club.
Okay. 手上拿着莲花大头棒
Sudarshan chakra, 神蝶 Okay, so the devotee always sees Krishna, they see Vasudev or the super soul in the hearts of everybody, the yogi anyway, he sees the super soul.
能在心中看见Vasudev超灵，而瑜伽师们他们只能看见超灵。And
the Gyanis, they just see the Brahman, the impersonal feature.
而Gyanis们只能看见非人格的特征Brahman。So
devotees, we think of the Paramatma within the heart, and we worship the deity in the temple.
奉献者们也会想着内心的超灵，同时奉献者会崇拜庙宇当中的神像。And
we also understand the impersonal Brahman.
奉献者同时也明白理解非人格的 Brahman.
So Bharat Maharaj was enjoying the kingdom according to the plan, according to the will of destiny. He ruled the world for a very long time and enjoyed with his wife and family. And when that period was finished, then he retired from family life and he renounced everything.
Bharat Maharaj就这样享受着王国，按照命运的安排，他享受了很长的时间，他和他的妻子一起享受着家庭生活。 然而，当时间享受的时间结束的时候，他便退出了家庭生活，放弃了一切。He
divided all of his wealth among his sons, and he left the home.
他把财富给儿子们划分给不同的儿子们，接着便离开了家。And
he went to a place in the Himalayas. Near to Hardwar.
他去了喜马拉雅山的一处名字叫Haridwar的地方。Haridwar
means the gate to Lord Hari, right? A very holy place. And the Ganga flows there. And they have also the place where Bharat Maharaj went. There was a river there which had the Shaligram Shilas.
Haridwar 是苦行的时候，旁边有一条河，里面有绍光石了巨石。
So Bharat Maharaj was there in the mountainous place, at this Pulaha Ashram, and the Lord appeared to him there.
Bharat Maharaj 就在山路边上一处叫 Pulaha 的 Ashram， 主就在那里向他显现。
The Lord comes in many different forms, as Lord Rama, as Balarama, as Narayan, or as Vishnu, many forms. His Lord is Anantarup.
主以各种各样的形象，比如说 Rama, Balarama, Narayana, Varaha 等等形象显现，他是 Anantarup。
So every devotee can decide which form they are attracted to, and they can worship that particular form of the Lord.
奉献者们可以自行决定受主的哪个形象吸引，便崇拜这一特定的形象。
And can worship the Lord in his deity form.
可以按照以形象的神像的形式来崇拜主。
So Krishna likes to reciprocate with the devotee according to the devotee's desire.
所以主会按照奉献者的欲望来回报这位奉献者。
So this place whereBharat Maharaj was staying. There's one river there called the Gandaki River, which is the best of all rivers.
Bharat Maharaj 苦行的地方呢，就旁边有一条河叫 Gandaki 河。
And in the Gandaki River, there are these marble pebbles, which are Shalagram Shilas.
而在 Gandaki 河当中呢，就有这个Shalagram Shila， 就是这些鹅卵石。
And on every one of these pebbles, these marble stones which are there, these Shalagram Shilas, on every one of them, there are circles. There are circles around these stones, which indicate a particular form of Lord Vishnu.
这每一个这个鹅卵石上面都有这些圆圈，就表明，是主的一个特定的形象。
So wherever the water of this river flows, that place becomes very pure.
无论这条河水流经哪里，那个地方就变得至为纯粹。
The worship of the Shalagram Shila is done by those who are twice initiated Brahmins.
只有二次启迪的 Brahmin 才有资格崇拜 Shalagram Shila.
You have to be very careful when you worship. If you don't worship properly, then you will get reaction.
崇拜 Shalagram Shila 的时候要非常的小心谨慎。否则的话就会得到反应。
So Maharaj Bharat, he lived up in this mountain place, up in this Pulaha Ashram, all alone he lived there.
Maharaj Bharat 是独自一人就在这个山上的 Pulaha Ashram 那里待着。
And he would have to collect flowers and tulsi leaves, and he would collect also some fruit and some roots and different things to eat and to offer to the deity and to maintain himself.
他必须要独自去采集鲜花、杜拉西叶子、水果、根茎、 这些食物来供奉神像，并且维系维生。
And of course, you take water from the Gandaki River and use the water also to offer for worship.
他也从 Gandaki 河当中取河水来供奉。
So he would offer everything to Lord Krishna, and in this way he was always satisfied.
他将一切都供奉给主 Krishna, 从而他感到至为的满足。
He had no more material desires. All his material desires had gone.
他没有任何的一丝一毫的物质欲望，所有的物质欲望都消失得无影无踪。
And he was doing very steady devotional service.
他的奉献服务非常的稳定。
In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, if you offer me with love and devotion a leaf, a flower, fruit, water, I will accept it. So he was doing that.
薄伽梵歌说，人如果怀着奉爱之心给我供奉一片叶、一朵花、一个水果或一些水，我将会接受。Bharat Maharaj 正是这样做的。
So,To worship the Lord, to worship Krishna doesn't cost a lot of money. It doesn't have to cost a lot of money.
崇拜至尊主 Krishna 花费一点都不昂贵。
Krishna just wants our love and devotion.
Krishna 只要我们的爱和奉爱之情。
So we want to purify our heart.We can do it by worshipping Krishna.
我们希望净化内心，就可以通过崇拜 Krishna 而做到。
But often people, they don't want to give up their material desires.
但是常常人们不想去除自己的物质欲望。
So we don't have to go to this place, we don't have to go up to Hardwar, we don't need to go in the mountains. We can do it wherever we are, we can do this kind of devotional service anywhere. Just offer these simple things to Krishna with love and devotion.
只需要怀着奉爱之情为 Krishna 供奉这些简单的物品。
So because he was doing like this, Maharaj Bharat became more and more pure, and he developed more and more love for Krishna, and until his heart was melting.
因为 Bharat Maharaj 这样做，他内心就变得越来越纯净，越来越满怀爱意。
All the hair on his,
他的心变成化了。
The hairs on his body would stand on end due to the ecstatic love for Krishna.
由于对 Krishna 的爱，他会毛发直竖。
And his eyes were always filled with tears. He could not even see anything because he was crying so much due to love of Krishna.
由于他眼中一直他会泪如泉涌，以致无法视物，因为他因为爱 Krishna 而不停地流着泪水。
And he would always meditate on the red lotus feet of Krishna.
他一直不断地冥想至尊主淡红色的莲花足。
So because he was so much in love, he was feeling ecstasy in the love of Krishna that he would forget about something, he would forget to do his services, the regulative service, like chanting mantras and offering prayers. He would forget to do all that because he was so much in love of Krishna.
Because he was so much in love of Krishna. 并且从此沉浸于这种狂喜当中，以至于他忘记了为至尊主做规定的服务，忘记了去念诵mantra 的供奉祷文。
So he was experiencing the ecstatic love, the bhava, or be called bhava. He had so much devotional service and ecstasy that he wouldn't be able to do all the regular duties which he would usually do.
他现在就处在bhava心，就是狂喜之爱当中的狂喜的奉爱。以至于他也就忽视了自己的规定的职责。
So Bharat Maharaj was a very handsome man, and he had long hair, but this hair was always wet because he'd take bath three times a day.
Bharat Maharaj 相貌英俊，他有着长发，但是因为他一天沐浴三次，他的长发都是湿漉漉的。
And he worshipped Lord Narayan by chanting the Vedic mantras.
通过唱诵伟达曼 mantra 来崇拜主 Narayan.
He covered his body in a deer skin.
他身裹一块鹿皮。
And he would chant these mantras like the Gayatri mantra he would chant sometimes. He would chant prayers from the Vedas to worship the sun god who is the manifestation of Lord Narayan.
Narayana, the 太阳神。
And Krishna also is in the heart of all living entities. So from the Bhagavad Gita, we know Sarvasya Jahamriti Sannivisto. Krishna says, I am in the hearts of all living entities. From me comes knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness. So we can offer prayers to Krishna in the heart as a super soul.
Krishna 也在内心，就像薄伽梵歌当中所说的，记忆、知识、遗忘都来自于我，因此我们可以向内心当中 Krishna 以超灵形象居住在内心的 Krishna 供奉祷文。
And we can worship Lord Narayan by chanting the Gayatri Mantra, which also prays to the sun god, who is manifestation of Lord Narayan. So Bharat Maharaj was one day, he was doing his duties. He had taken his bath and he was sitting down at the side of the Gandaki River and he began to chant his mantras.
就在甘达基河边坐下来，开始吟诵曼特。
So at that time he saw a deer came to drink water from the river.
此时他看到一头母鹿来到河边喝水。
And while the deer was drinking water, at that time a lion came very close. And it began to roar. It made a very loud sound, which was very frightening to everyone.
就在那头母鹿心满意足的饮水时，一头狮子靠近前来，并大声吼叫。这个吼声使每一个生物体都胆战心惊。
So the deer heard the sound of the lion, and The deer was terrified.
母鹿听到狮子狂暴的吼声，就变得非常的恐惧。
You know, the deer's nature is always thinking, he's always worried about some danger from others. So he's always looking who's coming, who's near, who's coming.
母鹿的本性就是担心其他的生物体会伤害它，因此一直会疑心重重地东瞧西望。
So when he heard that lion, the sound of the lion, he became very afraid.
母鹿听到狮子狂暴的吼声，就变得非常恐惧。
And although he hadn't even finished drinking water, the deer suddenly tried to jump across the river.
尽管他并没有喝够水，但还是突然纵身试图跳到河对岸。
But the deer was pregnant at this time. And when it jumped out of, when it jumped across the river, the baby deer who was in the womb fell out from the deer and it fell into the water of the river.
母鹿怀孕了，当她出于恐惧而跳跃时，她怀着的小鹿便从她子宫中掉到了河水。
So when the deer saw his young deer fall into the river, he became very sad, and he went into a cave and lay down in the cave and he died immediately.
因为母鹿失去了自己的鹿儿，他变得非常的忧伤。就当这头母鹿过河之后呢，他就跌到了一个山洞当中，立刻死去了。
So Bharat Maharaj saw this, and he saw the little baby deer floating in the river water. So he felt very sorry for the deer, so he got it out of the water and saved it.
伟大的巴特王坐在河岸，看到失去母亲的小鹿顺着河水向下漂流，这使他产生巨大的同情。他就从河水的波浪中托起幼小的鹿。
So he brought the deer to his own ashram to take care of it.
他把这头小鹿带回自己的灵修地，照料着这头小鹿。
So this is the beginning of the fall down of Bharat Maharaj. He was an advanced devotee, but he began to fall down due to this deer.
这就是 Bharat Maharaj 堕落的开始。他本来是一位进步的奉献者，却因为这头小鹿而堕落了。
So devotees have to be very careful and learn from the example of Bharat Maharaj.
奉献者们必须要非常的小心谨慎，从 Bharat Maharaj 的事迹当中吸取教训。
We have to be careful we have to learn how to get free from all material attachment.
我们必须小心谨慎，学习怎样摆脱所有的物质依附。
Bharat Maharaj got a problem because he showed compassion for the deer. That was a problem because you cannot make the deer into a devotee.
Bharat Maharaj 他的问题是他怜悯了这头小鹿，因为你不能把一头鹿变成一位奉献者。
You can't teach the deer how to chant. You can't teach him to be a vegetarian. You can't teach him devotional service because he's an animal. Animals cannot understand.
你无法教导一头鹿，无法教他怎么念诵成为素食者，无法教导他做奉献服务，因为他是一头动物，所以不会明白。
So real compassion is to bring people from the material platform to the spiritual platform.
真正的怜悯是将一个人从物质层面晋升到灵性层面。
If we don't do that, then we can fall down into the material platform, just like Bharat Maharaj is going to fall down.
如果我们做不到的话，就会堕落到物质层面，正如 Bharat Maharaj 的堕落。
So Bharat Maharaj became very attached to the deer. He used to give it grass, and he was always careful to protect it from other wild animals.
Bharat Maharaj 便开始用青草喂养小鹿。总是保护他免遭老虎和其他动物的攻击。
Sometimes he would kiss it, and sometimes he would cuddle it and hug it.
有时候他还会亲吻小鹿，或者是抚弄它。
So after a few days, he forgot everything about his spiritual advancement.
仅仅过了几天。他就把灵性进步忘得一干二净。
So we have to be very careful in doing our duties, not to forget the chanting of Hare Krishna.
我们一定要小心地履行各自的职责，千万不要忘记念诵 Hare Krishna.
We have to have a good sadhana.We should try to wake early in the morning, go to Arti, worship the deity, chant Hare Krishna.
We 必须要做好我们的 sadhana, 清晨早起做 Arti, 崇拜神像，念诵 Hare Krishna.
If we don't do these things, we can easily fall down.
如果不做这些活动，就能很容易的堕落。
Even though we may think we're advanced, we may be a sannyasi, but we can never give up the principles.
即便我们已经非常进步了，已经成为了 sannyasi, 也绝不能放弃原则。
We shouldn't think that now I'm advanced, I cannot fall down.
你不应该这样想，我现在已经进步了，我不会堕落了。
So we can learn from Bharat Maharaj how easy it is to fall down. Even though he was very advanced, he fell down.
我们可以从 Bharat Maharaj 那里学到堕落是这么的容易，即便他已经这么进步。
So in his mind, Bharat Maharaj was thinking, oh, this poor deer that Krishna arranged for me to save it and to take care of it.
Bharat Maharaj 便开始想哦，这头小鹿多么可怜呢 ！Krishna 就安排我来照顾它。
I have become its father and its mother and its brother. Everything, I'm everything to the deer.
我已经变成了这头小鹿的父亲、母亲、兄弟和它的一切。
And the deer loves me. It has faith in me. It trusts me.
这头鹿爱我，信任我。
So I should certainly protect it, take care of it.
所以我一定要保护它，照料它。
Even though the deer is disturbing my spiritual life, it's my duty to take care of it.
即便这头鹿已经干扰了我的灵修， 但我依然要好好地照顾他。
If I don't take care, that will be a big a fault on my part. Bharat Maharaj was thinking.
如果我不照顾这头鹿的话，那么这是大错特错了。所以 Bharat Maharaj 就是这样想。
So Srila Prabhupada comments that when person advances in Krishna consciousness, we feel sympathy when we see people suffering in the material world.
圣帕帕德在要旨当中评论说，有高度灵性意识的人会对物质世界里受苦的众生自然充满怜悯。
But that does not mean that we give our, that we should become sympathetic towards animals at the cost of our own spiritual life.
但这并不等于我们要以自己的灵性生命为代价，来去为了这个动物来牺牲自己的灵修。
If we should be sympathetic towards people and try to help people come to Krishna consciousness.
我们应该对人类心怀怜悯，努力地将帮助人类来具有 Krishna 知觉。
So Bharat Maharaj made a great mistake in giving up his spiritual practice just for an animal.
Bharat Maharaj 犯了一个大错误，他仅仅是为了一头动物而放弃了自己的灵性生命。
By the grace of Krishna, we can help people come to Krishna consciousness, but we have to follow the rules and regulations ourselves.
藉着 Krishna 的恩典，我们可以帮助人们来提升到灵性知觉层面上，但是我们自己必须要遵守规范原则。
Yeah, if we just worry about the bodily comforts of people, that is not good. That's not what we should be doing.
如果只是考虑他人躯体的舒适，这样并不好，这样并不合适。
This is very dangerous for us as devotees to worry too much about material situations.
这对于奉献者而言是非常危险的，仅仅去担忧其他人的物质境况。
Okay, we're going to stop there tonight. Are there any questions?
好，现在我们来看一下有什么问题吗？好，有一个小草，请问咕噜，经典说人到了50岁就应该退出家庭生活。我的问题是，既然有一天要离开家庭生活，为什么还要结婚呢？直接不结婚就好了吗？婚姻的意义是什么呢？So this devotee asked that since the scripture says after 50 years old one should retire from family life.My question is that since we have to live family life, why should we get married? We just don't get married. Is that okay? And what's the meaning of marriage?
Well, the point is that when you're young, there's people...generally have stronger, more passion in their body and more interest in the opposite sex. And that can be controlled and regulated by entering into family life.
轻的时候呢，他的躯体当中有很多的激情，也会对异性非常感兴趣。结婚呢，就能够控制，帮助他控制、规范他的生活。
And it also allows people to produce children who are very important because they're the future of the Krishna consciousness movement.
而且也允许人类繁衍后代，这对于 Krishna 之觉的未来是很重要的。
So it's a very important service to bring up children and train them to be devotees.
来抚养后代，并且训练他们成为奉献者，也是一项非常重要的服务。
However, as we get older, as you mentioned, from the age of 50, we have to start cultivating detachment. We have to prepare for the next life.
当我们上了年纪，到了五十岁的时候，就应该培养气绝精神，为来世做准备。
So the life is divided into these different sections.
生命就可以分成不同阶段。
In the beginning of life, student, we study, we get education.
学习阶段，成为学生，接受教育。
And then, from about the age 25, married life up to 50. Enough time to live together with the woman, have children, raise your children. And then, by the age of 50 or a little after, you retire from family life.
就结婚，一直到五十岁，这样他可以跟一个女子结婚生孩子。到了五十岁，或者是五十岁多一点，就退出家庭生活。
Wife can also stay with the husband in retired life. She doesn't have to leave.
妻子在退出家庭生活之后，妻子仍然可以跟丈夫生活在一起，无需离开丈夫。
But the relationship is not going to be like young people. They're not going to be thinking about having more children. They're not going to be thinking about economic development. Rather, their focus will be on spiritual practice.
但是这时候的关系已经不再像年轻时候那样子，他们不用再想着怎样生孩子、发展经济，他们应该专注于灵修。
So married life is a part of the, you know, people need to, some, most people need to go through it, and then after they've been through it, then they can give it up.
是大部分的人要经历的，经历了婚姻之后，经历了婚姻之后呢，就需要放弃了。
And then they can go on for perfecting their spiritual life.
他们可以继续下一个，继续他们的人生，来让他们的灵性生命达到完美。
Does this make sense?
您觉得这样的回答有意义吗？有道理吗？
我们等你回答。
小草。那可以。
Yeah.
Hare Krishna. Good day. 他说谢谢您，顶拜您。
这个是谁问的问题？
小草，我不知道是哪位奉献者。
小草 ，Brenda。 在呼和浩特，不知道。OK， 继续下一个问题。
好，下一个问题是 Shama Saki Devadasi Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Gurudev 和所有奉献者。我的问题是，那些 Dhyana 培养知识，崇拜 Brahman 梵光，而我不崇拜梵光，为什么还要学习 Bhakti Sastra 课程呢？还要背诵梵文、译文、课后作业，满脑子想这些，有时干到一半活想不起那一半要干啥了。 Gurudev， 您刚才讲的培养知识不包括博雅梵歌、瓦坛、至尊奥义书和奉爱的甘露这些书吗？再次顶拜 Gurudev。
Well, we're not trying to be gyanis, but we do need a little knowledge to understand the process of devotional service. We have to be able to convince people about the practice of bhakti yoga. And sometimes you have to have some knowledge, you have to know some philosophy a little bit.
我们确实需要一些，我们需要说服别人来了解 Bhakti Yoga， 所以我们需要知识，还需要哲学。
You don't need to know very much. Bhagavad Gita is just the ABC, primary study.
你不需要了解非常多，博伽梵歌是 ABC， 是初级知识。
You don't need to learn all this Sanskrit if you don't want to, but sometimes it can be useful. Sometimes it impresses people.
如果你没有这个愿望，你没有必要去学习这梵文，但梵文是有用的。这些梵文诗节呢，可以给人们留下深刻的印象。
Maybe in your situation, not so important, but young people, it's nice if they do it, if they learn it.
也许在您的情况下呢，学习这些梵文诗节并不是很重要，但对于年轻来说，年轻人学一些梵文诗节是非常好的。
People coming from more, you know, from the university background, you know, if they've been university education, they have a good education, and when they read the books, they see the Sanskrit, they should know something about what's there. What is the Sanskrit and what's the significance of it? Why it's important?
对于那些有大学受过大学教育的，有很好教育背景的人们，当他们看到书中的这些梵文诗节的时候，他们就能明白这个书是很重要的。
The Sanskrit shows the authentic nature of our teachings, that it comes from a very ancient tradition.
这些梵文就能够表明我们这个文化是有着权威的背景的，是来自一个古老的传统。
But it's not totally essential that you have to learn all these things. We just like you to chant Hare Krishna and to be happy in Krishna consciousness.
但是这些呢，并不是至关重要的。这重要的是念诵 Hare Krishna， 我们希望您在 Krishna 之节当中快乐开心。
OK， 下一个问题。
下一个还是小草，请问 Guru， 什么是过于担心别人的物质生活？就是我们可以关心别人的物质生活，但是不能过度，是吗？She asked What do you mean by taking care of others' material life too much? Does that mean that we can take care of others' material life, but not too much, the degree should not be too much. Is that right?
We should help people to come from the material position to the spiritual position.
我们当帮助人们从一种物质的地位来晋升到一个灵性的地位。
Right. We want them to understand first that they're not the body.
首先，我们希望人们理解他们不是这个这具躯体。
And everything actually belongs to Krishna. Krishna is the real proprietor, not us.
一切属于 Krishna. Krishna 是拥有者，我们不是拥有者。
And so we try to give people some understanding, some spiritual knowledge, spiritual education to save them from the miseries of material life.
给人们一些理解、领悟，在灵性上给予他们教育、知识，让他们摆脱物质的痛苦。The next.
Yeah.
下一个是刀姐。Bharat 如何做才能既保护自己不堕落，又能对小鹿展示恰当的仁慈，顶拜孤儿的莲花族。
Well, what it really needs was association. Bharat Maharaj did not have association there.He was alone. That's always dangerous.
他需要的是联谊。Bharat Maharaj 需要联谊，因为他总是独自一人，这是很危险的境地。
And the proper dealing with the deer, after he'd saved the deer, then, you know, he should let the deer go. Just let it go in the forest, let it go, and it's happy in the In the mountains, you know, he can live there quite, he'll be okay, he'll manage. Krishna helps. Doesn't need Bharat Maharaj to feed it and to kiss it and to hug it and all of this nonsense.
至于这头鹿的话，它可以让这头鹿自由地在山中生长。这对于这头鹿来说是 OK 没有问题的 Krishna 会帮助这头鹿他没必要去喂养它亲吻它来抚弄它这简直是没有意义的
We're not you know as devotees we are transcendentalistsBut we can't spend all our time just taking care of animals. We have to think of the welfare of people.
奉献者，身为奉献者，应该是超然主义者，而不能一整天的都去关注一头动物。奉献者应该关注是人类的福祉。The next question is from Leela Rasa Devadasi. 顶拜 Gurudev, 请问奉献者必须学梵文吗？我不会梵文怎么办呢？一点都不会。
No, we don't need to learn 梵文, but we should learn the prayers which we sing and which we offer every day. Like in the temple room, we sing songs. Some of these songs are in Sanskrit.We should be able to recite them.
我们不需要去学习梵文，但是我们需要学习祷文。我们要学习每天在庙宇当中要唱诵的那些祷文， 因为这些祷文是用梵文所谱写的，所以要把它们背下来。
We should be able to sing. When the devotees are singing, we should join in the song, the singing.
您应该 会唱，当奉献者开始唱诵祷文的时候，你也能够跟着加入他们一起唱诵。
You should know the meaning.
还应当了解这些歌曲的含义。
Yeah. At least we should know Panchatattva mantra.
至少应当熟知 Panchatattva 五圣体祷文。
And we should know how to offer the obeisances to Prabhupada. What is the pranam mantra to Prabhupada?
也要知道，帕帕德的顶拜祷文 Pranam Mantra。
Yeah, we should be able to say these things.
我们应当会念背诵这些祷文。
I remember when I got initiated from Prabhupada. Prabhupada wanted to hear all of, when I got initiated. We were about 12 people got initiation.So Prabhupada had each of us say his pranam mantra to make sure we knew his pranam mantra.
我还记得当我启迪的时候，我是帕帕德给马尔启迪的时候，当时呢一共同时有12个奉献者同时获得启迪。帕布帕德他希望听到每一个新启迪的奉献者来念诵他的Pranam mantra, 顶拜祷文。
Yeah, you want initiation, you should know at least this much.
如果您希望得到启迪的话，至少应当会这些。
Because you have to offer food to Krishna, you have to recite prayers also when you offer food to Krishna.
您必须要给 Krishna 供奉食物。那么你也必须要会那些供奉的祷文。
So usually when we offer food, we will say Prabhupada's Pranam Mantra, the Panchatattva Mantra, and Hare Krishna Mantra.
当供奉食物的时候，就要念诵 Prabhupada 的顶拜祷文、五圣体祷文，还有 Hare Krishna Mantra.
Okay, any more questions? 还有问题？
还有三四个，五个。下一个是 the next one。
Okay, 快一点啊。
迪迦沙提，快点哈。
因为大风快来了，大风快来了，我不，对，大风呀，有风呀，不知道电还有电多长时间，快一点念。
迪迦沙提问，就是瓦坛第一篇讲的是一些伟大灵魂的事情，没有讲创造，为什么题目却是创造呢？ The first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam tells the story of great souls, but doesn't mention creation. But why the title is creation?
Yeah.Well, creation is there. It's there. It may not be very prominent, but it is there.
第一篇讲到了创造，虽然不是非常突出，但是有创造的部分。
It comes up more in the second and third canto.
第三篇就更多的涉及到创造。The next one is from 智敏。这个马大吉说，在看今天读书，书中讲到说，在善良属性，的情况下就得到帮助和指导，能体验到与神连接的情感。那怎么达到创造属性？时期我经常感觉自己受激情属性影响，但是很渴望达到善良属性。
She wants to get to the mode of goodness.
Yes.
But she's in the mode of passion.
Yes, yes.
So how she's asking how to get to the mode of goodness?
Yes, she felt it's very difficult to get to the mood of goodness because she's in the mood of passion.
Well, you have to stop and look and think about what you're doing wrong. Why are you in the mode of passion when you should be in the mode of goodness? And you have to maybe make some changes in your life.
您需要停下来，然后内省，看看哪个地方出错了。你本来你应该处在善良属性当中，那就需要有些地方需要去改变。
Sometimes we have to just recognize that, you know, our lifestyle is not good. That we're too much in the mode of passion. We're too much attached.And we have to change our way of living and acting.
We need to admit our life lifestyle has problems. We are very passionate, very dependent. So we need to change our life lifestyle.
So we
need
to maybe take help from another devotee who is more in the mode of goodness.And they can tell you what you're doing wrong.
你可以从那些处在善良属性当中的奉献者得到他的帮助，他们指出您的缺点，哪个地方做的不对。
The mode of goodness can be cultivated by associating with people in the mode of goodness.
通过与那些处在善良属性的奉献者联谊，从而就培养出善良属性。
But you have to be willing to give up the bad habits.
您必须得愿意放弃恶习、坏习惯。
Maybe you watch too much television. Maybe you're too much thinking about money.
也许是看电视太多，或者是想的金钱的事情想太多。
Too much in the bodily consciousness of life.
过于处在躯体化生命概念当中。
Maybe you need to read Prabhupada's books more.
也许需要更多的读 Prabhupada 的书籍。
So we can come to the mode of goodness.By cultivating spiritual knowledge and regulating the senses.
通过培养灵性知识，规范感官，从而达到善良属性。
So read the Bhagavad Gita more. Chapter 2, Chapter 3, very important.And then read chapter 14 and 16.
阅读《摩诃梵歌》第二章、第三章、第十四章、十六章非常重要。
They will help you get out of the mode of passion and ignorance.
这能帮助你摆脱激情属性和愚昧属性。
下一个问题。
下一个问题方 Lila David Darcy 是顶拜 Guru 您讲过说利用别人服务 Krishna 没有坏处但是跟奉献者在一起的时候有奉献者不信任你能服务好 Krishna 怎么才算服务好怎么这个好有什么标准吗还有我们怎么看待奉献者不信任我们做服务比如说认为我做的饭没他的好吃必须亲自给 Krishna 做才放心或者是这个奉献者亲近的人做的饭他才放心 So you mentioned that it's not bad to use others to serve Krishna, but when we deal with devotee, they don't trust us that we can serve Krishna well. So what's the standard of good service? Are there any standard for good service?
Standard for good service is you should be regular, you should be steady in Krishna consciousness. They should be convinced that you're chanting 16 rounds and you're fixed in devotional service. And you come regular to associate.
Just
to
She further asked, so how the other devotees don't trust us, trust our service, so how to
deal with that? It takes some time. You have to be patient and get their confidence and get their trust. You have to show that you are steady and that you're serious. If you just come irregular once in a bloom, if you just come once in 3 months or once every 6 weeks, it's not enough. They need to see that you're regular, that you're really a devotee, you're serious.
如果你三个月才来一次，或者五周才来一次，并没有非常有规范的，他们就不会认为你是非常认真的。
下一个问题。
下一个，Puspa Sarah， 请问衣服家人和衣服小路会产生一样的果报吗？
Yes.
She asked.
The attachment to the relatives, is it the same as being attached to the deer? Yes, you'll come back in the family. Just as Bharat Maharaj was attached to the deer, he took birth in the family of deers, he became a deer in next life. You're attached to your family, you'll come back in the family some way.
是的，正像Bharat Maharaj，他衣服这头鹿，他来生就投生了一头鹿。同样，如果您衣服家人的话， 还会再投生在这个家庭当中。下一个问题。下个问题，方若真者，记忆和冥想有何区别？ What's the difference between remembrance and meditation?
Well, sometimes
Smarana and Dhyana.
Sometimes Prabhupada compares them the same thing. Sometimes Prabhupada says the same thing.
有时候Prabhupada说是一样的。
Yeah, he says, the third step in Bhakti Yoga is the seventh step in Ashtanga. So in Ashtanga Yoga, the seventh step is meditation, dhyana, and in Bhakti Yoga, the third step is remembering, smaran. So the same thing.
是巴迪瑜伽当中的第三部分记忆 is Dhyana, Ashtanga Yoga 当中的第七个阶段 Dhyana， 他说是一样的。下一个问题，最后个问题 Harini， 顶拜 Guru， 请问 Guru 可不可以祝福我多派 Krishna 的书，多派发 Krishna
书籍？好，我们祝福你多派书籍，很好 ，Harini。 多拍手，我们肯定我们祝福你这样很好。OK，今天结束了吗？可以吗？
没了，没有了。
Okay, Ganshi Guru Mani. Ganshi Sati.
Hare
Krishna. One an.
Lan.
Ding Pai Nyaman.